Good morning, everyone. Recently, I made a video talking about StyleGAN 2. It is the latest state-of-the-art GAN for unconditional image generation. It produces very good-looking faces and has improved many aspects compared to the original StyleGAN. This morning, I'd like to start a three-part series explaining how StyleGAN 2 works under the hood and showing you how I implemented it in Tensorflow 2.0. This video assumes you have at least a basic knowledge of GANs and convolution. If you're not familiar, that's okay. Check out some of my other tutorials, then come back to this one. Jumping right in, the first improvement StyleGAN 2 made was in revisiting adaptive instance normalization. They replaced this with something called convolution modulation and demodulation, which I will get to in a moment. Adaptive instance normalization, or AdalN if you don't have much time, is a method of applying a style to the feature map of an image. AdalN takes a feature map, normalizes it, then rescales the feature map based on a style vector with scaling values for each feature map. In this paper, they define this as first demodulating a feature map, then modulating the feature map with a given style. The original StyleGAN would demodulate, then modulate feature maps immediately. The authors revisited this. They define a style block as any operations done between modulation and demodulation. This is where feature maps are changed using convolution, and the modulation of them applies certain features more than others. In the original StyleGAN, all operations were done inside the style block. The authors thought that it wasn't necessarily a good thing to be adding inconsequential noise with a set scale to modulated feature maps which had a variable scale. Thus, they revised the architecture to move this inconsequential noise to be outside of the style blocks, as you can see here. Now, each style block modulates the input feature map, uses convolution, then demodulates the output feature map. What the authors then changed was genius, in my opinion. They realized they could get the exact same effect by modulating and demodulating the convolution kernel weights without doing all the calculations of modulating and demodulating the input and output feature maps, respectively. Here, I'll go into more detail about convolution modulation and demodulation. Here is an example of what a set of image feature maps might look like with three channels, red, green, and blue. Here is an example of what a convolution layer might look like, going from one set of feature maps to the next. Each line represents some convolutional kernel. This kernel goes over the entire feature map, but for simplicity, they are simply represented here as lines from one feature to the next. To get the same effect as scaling the input feature maps, we can scale each kernel based on their input channel. All kernels with the same input would have the same scale. This scaling factor is determined by the style vector, thus being affected by the latent input, modulating differently for each image. Now, to complete the style block, the outputs must be demodulated, which means normalizing them to have a standard deviation of 1. Assuming the inputs have a standard deviation of 1, since they were also normalized at one point, we can normalize the outputs by dividing the modulated weights by their L2 norm. Thus, convolution demodulation divides each modulated kernel by the L2 norm of all the weights leading to each output. Now, the entire style block has been baked into the convolution layer, greatly speeding up processing. But other than speeding things up, did it help with anything? Actually, yes. The original StyleGAN had these little droplet artifacts that you can see here. In each image, and as part of the feature maps, AdalN would need little pieces where the feature maps had very extreme values caused by the way it normalized the feature maps. With modulated convolution, these droplet artifacts go away. This is a video from the authors showing this improvement. Let's jump into the code for this modulated convolution. If you want to see the full code, the GitHub link is in the description. I implemented a custom Keras layer for modulated convolution. There's a pretty hefty amount of code, but a lot of it is just configuring the layer itself, copied from the original convolution implementation. The only important part of this code is the call function. The first thing I did was change my configuration to channels first instead of channels last. This just made reshaping easier later in the function, and I change back to channels last at the end of the function. Now, we have two inputs, one with the feature maps and one with the weight scaling values. We want to reshape the weight scales so that they're compatible with our kernel. Then, we want to add a mini batch layer to our kernel, as the weights will be different for each instance in the batch. Now, we move on to modulating and demodulating, just like what we looked at. We multiply the kernel with the input weights. Then, we get the L2 norm of the weights based on their output weights and divide by that value. What we do next is a little complicated, but please bear with me. Since convolutional kernels can't have a batch size in TensorFlow 2.0, we need to fuse all instances of the kernel weights in a batch to all be in a single layer weight instance. We also need to fuse all inputs so that they're all feature maps of a single instance, to make up for the fusing of the kernels. This was a headache to do and would be a headache to explain, so I'll just leave it at that. The important thing is that you understand the concept of modulation and demodulation. So now, once that's done, we can finally apply the convolution. Then we unfuse the output, putting it back to being a batch, and go back to the channel's last configuration. And that's it. We have our modulated convolution layer, which we can now use in our model. Here we see the new code for a generator block. First, we get the values for the style vector from the mapping network and scale the inconsequential noise. We then use our modulated convolution with the image features and style vector, add our consequential noise, and then apply a nonlinearity function. So that's it for convolution modulation. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe to catch parts 2 and 3, which will go over the other improvements StyleGAN 2 made. Thanks for watching.